السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى سرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، أما بعد. وغلوريفاي ألميت الله We praise him. We show gratitude to him. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah, of power and over to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions and his household to the day of judgment. Almighty Allah says in Al Quran Al Azim, O you who believe, fear Allah, we are for you. Fear Allah. Be afraid of Almighty Allah. Then Almighty Allah says for them, and do not return to me except you die in state of Islam. Surrenderness. Inshallah, my brother and sister in Islam, today's khutbah, I would like to continue with the advice of one of the Sahaba of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu. Last week, we mentioned three about this advice. Today, inshallah, we will end up that three for us. Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu said, من جمع ست خصال, whomever that Almighty Allah has blessed to the day that he combine all of these six, he follow it, then Almighty Allah out of his mercy, Almighty Allah will make him closer to Jannah and distance such person from the hellfire. Like I said previously, we mentioned three, but it remains three. Then Sayyidina Ali continues saying, من عرف الباطل فاجتنبه. Who among you who recognize falsehood and stay himself away from that? So there is difference between both. Because in many cases, we may know that this is wrong. But because of our interest, it's going to be hard for us to make us abstain from that. But if you caution yourself, out of nafs al-hawa, the desire soul, definitely you would go into the position that Sayyidina Ali karamallahu wajhahu is talking about. Let me give us good example on that. You see, in this life, when we want to preach something, or we have something that we want to follow, like culture, we advocate, we have advocates to say that this is good. Maybe many of us, we know that it's not good. But because of our interest, like I mentioned, we have some people like that. And at the same time, we have followers, those who will support that. Similarly happened in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was Almighty Allah and Prophet to abolish the belief in their idols. they believe that either is the God or not, they have to go along with that. Some of them knows. Some of them, because of their interest, so they have to follow. So let's go down so that we can understand more better from what exactly happened in our life that we are living today. Majority of us, we know that this is wrong, this is right. We know that. For instance, in terms of transaction, dealing with each other, I know that if I embezzle your money or your property, Allah is going to ask me. But because at that moment, I believe that I have power, so I have to use that power. And if you can try by all means to caution yourself out of that, then this is what Sayyidina Ali is trying to tell us. Because he knew that it's something that can ruin our life. Let's compare this life that we are living at this moment with the oldest one. Our grandfather, Wallahi Lazim, they live successful life. That's why they don't have the technology. They don't have more knowledge that we acquire today. But because of the trust, Almighty Allah makes things easy and put the baraka for what they are doing then. But today, with our technology, with our power, with whatever that we have, the life is more tougher for us. Why? We need to ask ourselves. Because we believe in cheating. Because we believe in deceiving. So how Almighty Allah going to put the baraka from that? We are a transaction or dealing in Islam is permissible. Because Almighty Allah know that all of you are going to be benefits. You're going to be benefit. What I don't have, maybe you have it, then I need it. What you don't have, maybe I have it, you need it. That's why Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran, even Almighty Allah says, when you are going to Saudi Arabia, Mecca, Al-Mukarram, to worship Almighty Allah, once you're done, why not? You can make trading. Allah says in Al-Quran al-Azim, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاهُمْ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَدِلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Almighty Allah say, it's not sin for you when you have done by worshipping Almighty Allah and you are looking for the bounty of Almighty Allah among yourself. It's permissible. Almighty Allah says in Al-Quran Al-Azim. But today, like I say, we don't even care. We consume haram. I don't know your right for you. You don't know my right for me. So this is what Islam is trying to abolish in our society. All this corrupted our society. In the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one day, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was just walking into the market where they were selling this food stuff. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam just sensed to in one place that they put some water in that food down there. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, where is the owner of this? And the owner came out. فقال Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم سي ما هذا يا صاحب الطعام tell me what are you trying to do what's this and the man replied Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم he said I did that due to the rain because just rain fell on that That's the reason why. Then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, why can you not put the one that mastering on top so that people can see what they want to sell? Don't you know that if they bought it like that and go home, they were not happy? You think that money gonna be useful for you? Your barakah will be diminished. This is the teaching of Islam. But today, we don't care. We don't care. That's the reason why Sayyidina Ali Karam Allah Wajahu said. He mentioned what he said to caution ourselves from all of this. Once this happened again, this happened to Abdullah, the son of Sayyidina Umar, radiallahu anhu. Abdullah took one of his students, Nafi' by name, to the market. And he saw a good camel that he wanted to buy. Tell me, after this, if you can do it, if I can do it. And he said, how much this camel? The seller said, 8 dirham. He said, you sure 8 dirham? He said, yes. And this Abdullah ibn Umar was the one that wanted to buy the camel. And he said, okay, I'm going to give you 10. To add 2 dirham more. The man say, I say 8. He say, yes. This is what I love to do. And the man say, okay, pay that. Then after that, Sayyidina Abdullah, the son of Umar, raised the money again. From 8 to 16 dirham. The man said, okay. And he gave the man 16 dirham instead of 8 dirham. Now, his student, nephew, on their way, see that, my master, my teacher, what's going on? The man said 8, but you paid 18. What's going on? Abdullah ibn Umar said to his student, I learned this from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, La yuminu ahadukum atta yu'ibba li akhihi ma yu'ibbu li nafsi. What Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying regarding to that? That no one of you, La yuminu ahadukum call himself a believer. Atta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsi. Until what he loves to himself to love for the others. He say, because if I want to buy that or to sell that, I will sell it in the same price. So that's the reason why I did that. My brother and sister in Islam, me and you today, even though if I know that you worth 8 dirham or 18 dirham, I will try by all means in order to let me pay maybe like 2 dirham. I don't care about the others. Imagine, my brother and sister in Islam. So number 5,
والخامسة من عرف الدنيا فأعرض عنها. Then Sayyidina Ali Karamallahu Wajhahu say, anyone who understands this dunya, the function of this dunya, the life that we are living, and study very well, then move away from that. Sayyidina Ali did not say that we shouldn't be in this world or do whatever necessary. No. But we have to recognize that this life itself, without the worship of Almighty Allah, is meaningless. If we're always busy with dunya, without knowing Almighty Allah who created this dunya and created us, then the life is meaningless. This verse is trying to tell us, because piling up of this dunya, goodness of this life, Al-Hakum Takafir. Almighty Allah say, Al-Hakum Takafir, piling up of the goodness of this life, Shagalakum, is going to make you busy. It's going to make you busy. Fil amwal wal awlad. More. In terms of wealth. More. In terms of children. That's why Almighty Allah say in Al-Quran and Surah Al-Hadid, for me and you, Almighty Allah say, إِلَمُوا أَنَّمَ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا لَعِبٌ وَلَهْوٌ وَزِنَّةٌ وَتَفَاخُرُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَتَكَاثُرُ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ. Almighty Allah says, keep it in your mind. Let me explain this dunya. Let me explain this dunya for you. إِلَّمُ أَنَّمَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Almighty Allah say, لَعِبٌ. In order for you to understand better, لَعِبٌ. لَعِبٌ from, start from like a baby. When you have a baby, like maybe like 2 months, 3 months, 5 months, 6 months, what did you know? He knew nothing. It's going to playing. Almighty Allah, that's life, number one. That's first stage. Wallahun. When he reached another certain age, maybe like 6, past time, he won't know anything than to play. And remember, the life is going. Then continue, وَزِنَّةٌ. And again, when he reached maybe like 12, 13, 14, then adornment, shining, anything shining. This time that you're going to say, I like this, I like that, I like that. You see? The age from stage one stage to another. Then وَزِنَّةٌ. Then وَتَفَاخُرْ بَيْنَكُمْ. That one is like from 20 up. This is the time that he's going to say that, you see, look at the brand name that I bought in time of shirt, in time of cap, in time of everything. Among boasting mutually among themselves, friend, community. this house going to do? If he neglected Almighty Allah, with this opportunity, the time is going. Then Almighty Allah say, another stage. وَتَكَاثُرْ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْحَوْلَاتِ وَتَكَاثُرْ piling up. When you reach maybe like 30 up, this is the time that you get good job, making good figure. 70,000 in a year, 100,000. Takasur fil amwal. From there, he moved to another job. Takasur fil amwal. Then later on, he's going to be settled to marry. You see, the time is going. And he forgot Almighty Allah. He neglected Almighty Allah. This time around, is around maybe like 45, 50 years. He did not know Almighty Allah. Takasur fil amwal wal hulad. He continued. Time is going. Then Almighty Allah say, later on when they ask him, oh, how many children that you have? 7, 8. In fact, he's going to finish college next year. In fact, he's working in World Trade Center. So. That's not the life. That's not the life. Allah did not just created us for that without knowing Almighty Allah. This is what Almighty Allah is trying to let us know. We as a Muslim. Then Almighty Allah say, you see, if you don't know Almighty Allah with that, Allah say, kama salil gaist ajabal kuffar nabatu thumma yahiju fatarahu musfaran thumma kunu hutama. Almighty Allah say, let me give you the example of that. How this man gonna hand up? How this woman gonna hand up without knowing Almighty Allah? Of course, you see everything shining, delightfully make him happy. Then Almighty Allah see, it's like a farmer who planted fruit or whatever, and everything delighted. In fact, maybe he counted, say, okay, by 6 months to come, I'm going to make millions. But all of a sudden, Almighty Allah just send wind to everything. Everything destroyed when it's come to yellow. What are you going to do? Then Almighty Allah say indirectly that this is the time that you will not be able to enjoy anything because the death is going to be overtake you very soon. Maybe at the age of 60. Maybe at the age of 70. What are you going to do for Almighty Allah? You're not useful for Almighty Allah. Allah doesn't need you at this moment because you wasted a lot of time that you're supposed to use for Almighty Allah. Even though if you are eating, your digestive system will not be okay as you want at this moment. So what is enjoyment? That's the reason why Almighty Allah say, from the really time that you're supposed to worship Almighty Allah, try by all means. That's why Sayyidina Ali is trying to show us the sign, the real life that we are living at dunya. If we do that, we caution ourselves out of nafs hawa, desire soul, then we are able to be in the place that Sayyidina Ali is trying to introduce for me and you. Lastly, Sayyidina Ali say, من عرف الجنة فطلبها. He won't really believe that about the existing of Jannah, paradise. try to search for it by all means. Imagine, since that we are born, me and you, all those who are going to listen to me, how many times they spread red carpet for me and you in this life? What if we are traveling, maybe first class, and some people came with security and they mentioned your name in the airport that, oh, so-so-so person, just come.